dun da dun da dun 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 da dun dun da dun da dun dun da da dun dun da 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 dun dun da da dun. Psych. Sorry, I had so much fun doing that last time. Oh, let me move over so you can see me. And we'll do a thing. Hi! It's me, it's Tobias. Slightly repositioned, slightly different size card thingy. And I have no idea if this is going to work or not, but this is show 30. We have somehow managed to do 30 of these things, counting this one. I am as surprised as anyone is, to be honest with you. I mean, let's be honest about this. I decided to start doing this 30 of these shows ago because, well, I wasn't going to be able to perform out there, so I might as well do it here. So I hope it's been fun for y'all. It certainly has been fun for me. Let me do one thing real quick here and... focus on me, camera. Can't get the camera to focus on me. There. Well, close enough for rock and roll. All right. It is May the 7th, and this is the last show of the week. I'm going to be doing some stuff I have done before. I'm going to do some, well, pretty much all of it I have done before, but there's one I haven't done very often. I just did it last time. Yes, the show is almost as old as Kay. Well, Kay, lad... I have emotional scars older than you. And I mean that with all due respect and love. But yeah, it's 30 shows, man. That's almost... this show should start thinking about a 401k. Ah, I killed myself. Let's go ahead and leap into it, shall we? Let's see, what am I doing first? I'm going to do this one first. Yes, because I enjoy it. This is a I am hankering for fair kind of day. And this was actually one of the first filks that I ever wrote. And I was told, oh no, we've done that one, by a certain party who shall remain nameless and probably doesn't even remember it because it was kind of de facto to decide that any idea I had come up with in my early, overly enthusiastic fair career as part of a certain organization was clearly someone must have thought of it before. And if I sound just a little cynical about it, well, I am. Can't face another drunk with an axe. Parade is coming and I can't relax. Can't sleep, tent's not up. Dirt and Gatorade are in my cup and psycho patron. God give you good day. Ha 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 ha, huzzah, huzzah, better. Make way, good gentles, make way. Hey, 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 psycho patron, God give you good day. Ha ha ha, huzzah, 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 better. Make way, good gentles, make way. You can't even finish it. You're shouting a lot, but you're not really saying anything. When I have nothing to say, I'll improv and mime. If it's funny once, it'll be funny again. Psycho patron, God give you good day. Huzzah, better. Make way, good gentles, make way. Heed what I say, psycho patron. God give you good day. Huzzah, huzzah, better. Make way, get out of the way of the parade. Yeah, 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 yeah. Did you make that? Do you live here? Hey, are those real? Where's the beer? Posters say come out and play, and they drop $50 to walk around and stare all day. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oy vey. We are hot and we are tired, and there's 1,000 crazy people in this shire. Echo Patron, God give you good day. Huzzah, better make way, good gentles, make way. Heed what I say, Psycho Turkey, God give you good day. Huzzah, better make way, get out of the way! Jeez, what's wrong with you people? Of the nothing like a little bit of talking heads, Phil, to get your head cleared and get you all good and wired up, including this particular one, which is about something everyone who has ever done a parade or been in a parade or watched a parade from the sides and watch people just kind of blithely stand there and stare off into the middle of the distance while this entire mob of people comes slowly steamrolling down the lines. We'll appreciate. Honestly, I should say something, because I don't know if the term turkey carries from the West Coast over. That is not a terribly endearing term that we used in the West Coast to describe customers who were completely oblivious to their surroundings. Do that kind of Patrick Stewart and Ghost kind of lost walk on his shoulders, and knees and shoulders are kind of in unison, and they don't know really what they're doing or where they're going. But they will come to a complete dead stop directly in front of you as you are desperately trying to make your way to your next gig, your next show, the privies, anything really. Now, we love our customers. Without the customers, we are a sleepaway dress-up day camp. That's not good for anybody. That's not healthy for anyone. I want to do another one. There's a lot of filks this show. And filks are loving adaptations of existing songs with new lyrics. And sometimes they're loving adaptations, and sometimes it's like, this is clearly funny, I have to write this. This next one, actually, the first verse of The Man Who Sold the World starts with, I met him on the stair. And my brain looked at it and went, I met him at the fair. Crap, now I have to write that. Fine! And actually took a while to write, because I wasn't entirely confident in my abilities, but it's turned out reasonably well, and so I'll do that one for you this next time here. Next thing? Yes. Fairly certain I can play this. The chords I can play, it's all the finger riffs that are been like deaf on horseback this week, so let's see what happens. Yeah. I met him at the fair. We spoke of where and when. Although he was not there, he'd comped me as a friend, which came as some surprise. My act never caught his eye. I thought he'd driven home a long, long time ago. I never change my clothes. We'll get it. Your face, with a man who lives at fair. I laughed and shook his hand, and drank from his own flask. Went back to my homeland. I knew what I should have asked. I gazed and stared at all the folks at fair. We should have driven home long, long time ago. Oh no, not us. We never change our clothes. You're face to face with the folks who live at Faire. Oh no, not me. I never change my clothes. Your face with a man who lives at Faire. So close. So close. Boating accident. Kayaking incidents, as Kay puts it. I get wobbly. Oh, I'm back up. Oh, we're fine. It's when I perform for my wife, who is my biggest supporter and my staunchest critic, she will tell me that frequently the things I think of are mistakes no one else notices. And if I didn't have such an expressive face and vigorous tells when I screw up, then that probably wouldn't be as much of an issue. But I still love the songs. I actually played that song out front of the Privy Bank by the Elephant Ride one day a few years ago. And because I was just wasting, I was killing time. I was waiting for my wife to come out. And I actually got a compliment from a couple of people, including the vendor of the at the fruit stand, who asked to be there and see everything all day long. So I kind of felt that was good. There it is. Bass it. And then I boofed that boating accident right there, but that's okay. No one's paying me to do this, and no one's paying you to watch, so we're all kind of in this together. All right, let's do the next song. The next song is another Filk. What? Another Filk? Yes, no kidding, this one. I have been told that I have a tendency to... I sometimes drift into a drawl or twang, and I think that's partially because I'm kind of channeling Joe Walsh. Now, I am not Joe Walsh. Joe Walsh is an incredibly talented man who can basically play any musical instrument with strings on it. And it's a true fact. I mean, he's just really dang good. So, fairly certain. Any puns that are occurring during this show are, in fact, entirely unintentional, Kay and Kaylee. No, that was not intentional. It just comes out of my brain, and I generate these things. And then we all deal with it one way or the other. Let me see if I can do the riff. Why am I asking you? Okay. A little bit. light it up. My costume's made up of burlap and cloth. Takes twice as long to put on than take off. My boots are old, not too quick to pull on, but I gotta wear them to go to the John. Don't quite know what I'll be doing today. Better. The show goes on. To building suspense. One day I'll learn it. I'm a horrible human being. I do this Ren Fair every year. Beat up my body to get a few cheers. How long I'll do this darn thing, I don't know. But if they're gonna hold it, well, I guess I'll go. The place of thing. It's packing years into just a few days. Fair has been good to me so far. I scared a cat. A little carried away there. I do have a lot of fun with that. Just kind of running that desperately into the ground. But I also reminded myself here, I am a tenor. I have a very short neck, not long neck, short neck, broad chest. Highly trained attack tenor. And there are some songs that are just, I can go up, I can go down. Fair has been good to me so far. Actually, works better if I do my impression of Joe Walsh while I'm singing it, because then I want to go up higher. I got a camper, forget the price. See, I can't even get that right some days. Now, the next song I'm doing is a new one. I did it yesterday. I'm going to do it today, and hopefully I'm going to get it at the right pitch, because I feel like I was too low, and it was right at the fry level. So we'll see. But this is the... This is the Ren Faire equivalent of Internet Famous, which I will doubtless do again next week, because I'm going to do it, because I like the song and I have a lot of fun with it. And let me grab the right screen here, because I don't know it perfectly yet. And if you're hearing a rattling in the background, that is our two-year-old cat, Domino, who has a collar with tag and is currently on a plastic stack of bins, grooming ferociously. Because that's what cats do. So we're killing time here. Here it is. All I want is everyone love me. There we go. That's the one. Yeah. It was harder to come up with an equivalent to Internet Famous, because Ren Faire Famous just didn't, there's no sense in adapting that. But I think what really settled it for me was, why do we do this? Well, we do it because it's fun, but we also do it because there's a connection that we can make with patrons out there and with our fellow performers, and even with booth and with boothies and with stage acts. And I've been all of these. I have not been staff. I have not been ops staff, so that's one thing that's still beyond me. But when you get right down to it, there's something that Faire, there's a need that Faire fulfills in us for reasons which are still completely unclear. I may have gotten close. Another idiot in burlap wandered through a blasted pasture, trying to get attention from the people in the shire. I got it. Another idiot in burlap asking out to get some attention, just wants to be famous, if only for a while. I'm going too high. I think I'll compromise. There's no what I think now. All I want is for everyone to love me. All I need is for everyone to care. All I desire is just unbridled admiration. I want to be the most important person at the fair. See, that fry is still killing me. I'm going to have to cheat. Wow. You ever have one of those moments where you're just honestly trying to figure out how you're going to bail out of this particular problem? When you can see the boating accident, it's just like, here comes the iceberg. Good luck. Yeah. Got the acting bug in high school, renting costumes, they look so cool. Hitched my wagon to the fair to see where I could go. Found it! These villagers are my sis and brothers, all shouting louder than the others, cause at Rent Faire, everyone's the star of their own show. And all I want is for everyone to love me. All I need is for everyone to care. All I desire is just unbridled admiration. I want to be the most important person at the fair. I worked all year to make my costume, hand sewn every single button. The research that went into this just borders on obscene. So pardon me if I sound grumpy, but I feel so blasted frumpy. Watch that one get all the attention just cause she's the queen. Now all I want is for everyone to love me. All I need is for everyone to care. All I desire is just unbridled admiration. I want to be the most important person at the fair. Ever one of those moments where you're trying to sing a song and you know it's in your key and you can't figure out where the heck it is? Well, I'm clearly doing that right now, which is really kind of embarrassing. But since this is not a real show, I don't feel quite so bad about it. I almost feel like I should do something to redeem myself. What do you think? Should I do something to redeem myself? Yeah, let's do something. Let's do one more thing. This is a completely unscheduled, and I'm just going to do a thing here, thing. And what am I going to do? All I want is for everyone to love me. That sounds right in my head, and it just comes out of my mouth, and it just doesn't quite hit the right place, which I don't understand, but there it is. And it's okay. And y'all are like, oh God, I hope he's not going to hurt himself. Oh, I'm going to hurt myself. Because, you know, you're gonna do something dangerous and stupid, which is kind of the hallmark of my show, then what you should do is you should go in, prepare to go big, and just say, dang the torpedoes, full speed ahead. Every time I do this show, there's a part of me that says this could be the last time I do it, because I'm doing this as a break from commuting, from driving home. And I always want to end big. You want to end the show big. And this is about the biggest it gets. Well, let's see if I can do it. Long may the burlap wave. It protects us again from the sun and the rain. The road into heaven is paved with burlap both coarse and fine. It covers our heads and linens our beds, much stronger than lace and much softer than twine. majestic and proud. It's a dance in the air. Our great savior, burlap, that ne'er leaves us bare, with colors of both bold and pure. It blocks out the sun when it is well hung, and none can escape its lure. For men sail across the sea, they fight mighty wars, sell their daughters for hoes to be under its cover like me. Here we go! Majestic and proud, a burlap doth wave. And when I am dead, hang an old sackcloth upon my poor grave. Just fly in the sky, the don't know where you're going. I am going to continue to work on All I Want because I'm pretty sure the pitch is in there somewhere and I have yet to find it. And that's two for two and it's kind of embarrassing, but y'all are with me and I think you're all supportive of me and I appreciate the heck out of that. All right. Well, yeah, blah, blah, money, blah, 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 whatever. In the event that you decide you want to throw some money at me, here's how you can do it. And I appreciate the three people who have been crazy enough to do that because that will do things like get me more video equipment and, singing lessons, apparently, and maybe someone to actually figure out what the heck key I'm in at any given moment. SoundCloud, blah, 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 recorded stuff. We'll be recording more stuff. I have a microphone. I have all the stuff. And I can actually try and do, like, studio versions of it, of a lot of the songs I've been doing for you right here. And they'll go there at SoundCloud.com, and they'll also go over... The shows will be over at Tobias the Adequate on Facebook, you know, because that's where I put them. I also put them up on YouTube, which is located right there, youtube.com/mplegare, because the Adequate was already taken at the time that I got a YouTube channel, which is weird because nobody else took the Adequate and everything else that I could tell. Carpe Diem Comics is, of course, the official emotional support comic shop of Tobias the Adequate, the Troubadork Show, anything else that I'm involved in. They're located in McKinney, Texas. They're currently open at limited capacity, but you can go to their website, carpediemcomicsonline.square.site, and buy stuff from them that way too. Always a good idea. Also, this is your daily reminder to support your local comic shop, your local craft store, your local gaming shop, all the locals, because they don't have massive corporations behind them. And I'm not sure if they're going to, and you know, although we'd all like to think that everybody gets some of that sweet stimulus money, it can be a little iffy. So support them and they'll stick around. Patreon.com/theadequate is, of course, your way to support Adequacy in our lifetime. I currently have 4 Patreon patrons, and I'm as amazed as you are. They are basically pitching in $1 or $2 a month, and that goes towards the fund to get more microphones and cameras and singing lessons and stuff like that. Thank you once again to John and Brian and Laureen and Alysia. Y'all continue to bewilder me with your generosity. 30 shows. 30 shows. Have I gotten better? Have I gotten worse? I sometimes worry that I'm actually getting worse because, well, let's be honest about this. I am certainly experiencing a slow and gradual decline into insanity and general decrepitness. I'm 52 years old. That's younger than some of y'all. That's not as young as some of y'all. That's not as old as some of y'all. But I can never tell that I'm actually good at this or not. It's hard to tell from this side. I hope you all have enjoyed it. I will be coming back next week because we are definitely working from home again the next week. And then things get iffy. Of course, things are iffy here in Texas anyway, because we have slightly more unpredictable government out here. But do come back. I will do more stuff. I will see if I can write some more songs. I'll see if I can play some more songs. And I hope we can all have a good time doing it. And until then, this is your old friend Tobias saying... Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Be careful out there. And if you're going to go out driving, if you're going to go out driving later, do not forget your car. That's practical, practical, practical advice.